Time to continue with the motor mount. Last video was a bit of a disappointment, but I think I got those problems solved now. Let's see, what did I do? First I reversed the current, which made a huge difference. The motor somehow isn't bumping around as much when running in the right direction. I don't know why. That still got me puzzled. And then I replaced the bearings. I was hoping that that would make a difference, but it didn't. Next, I placed some rubber pads on the, all the corners of the lathe, hoping that that would dampen any vibration. No noticeable change there. Then I put some extra tension on the spring by changing the mounting bracket. Then I tried a few different belts, and they were all used ones, and they didn't make much difference. And then I found a old stock one, which had a bit of dry rot, and that one is working a bit better. There's less vibration in the lathe now. It's actually the belt that's on there now. I also found out with this belt that the grooves in my pulley weren't deep enough, so I also had to recut those. After all these changes, I still had a bit of vibration on the lathe. It wasn't as bad as before, where I could actually see the tool post just shaking a bit. There's one more thing that I wanted to try, and that's what I'll show you next. I made up a small bracket that I can use to lock the motor mount in place. I didn't want to do this because this will increase the amount of things that you need to do to change the belt, but it really makes a big difference. With this bracket locked down, there is less vibration in this lathe than on my cheap Chinese lathe, so that's a good thing. And when I installed a nice, easy to operate knob on here, I guess belt changes won't be a problem. I'm going to demonstrate the effect of this bracket. So I'll run the lathe and you can see it, the mower moving around, and then I will lock it up and you hopefully see the difference. The effect is very easy to feel if you lay your hand on the headstock. I think maybe a new belt might make a difference, because this one has a bit of dry rot, although I do think it's getting better. I guess it's loosening up a bit. So now I'm gonna measure the speed for all three pulley settings at different frequencies, starting with 10 Hertz. Okay, here we go. This is 10 Hertz. That's about 50. It's 20 Hertz. About 100. 30 Hertz, about 150, 40 hertz, almost 200, 50 hertz, almost 250, and 60 hertz, about 290. All right, I'm going to measure the rest of them and write them down. And here are the results. I especially like the ones for the fastest pulley combination. I averaged things out to half a decimal. So that really worked out nice. I don't think that 10 hertz will be all that usable. There won't be a lot of power. 20 hertz might also be a problem. But I think this is a nice range for these plain copper bearings. And I can always go faster than 600 by overdriving the motor a bit more. It's now limited at 60 hertz, but I think I can go to 120 hertz. But that will be too much. 70, 80 hertz, I don't think that will be a problem for these motors and these bearings. But running faster than 600, I don't think it will be... well, I'm not sure if these bronze bearings can take it. Let's see if I can stop this thing running at 10 hertz. No problem. Right, let's try again. Yeah, it's slipping on the small pulley. It's slipping on the big pulley and the small one. There might be a bit oil on the belt because the oil from the bearing is leaking down here. So when you change the belt, you can get some oil in there. Because when I tried this before, I wasn't able to stop it. So I'm a bit surprised that I can stop it that easy now. Let's try the big one as well. Again at 10 hertz. Yep. Slipping on the small pulley. Well, that's easier than expected. I guess I'll... well, once I got that new belt, I'll try again. Well, that's it for now. Next will be some test cutting after I adjust the bearings as good as I can.